Right, so I even updated the score and everything.
So hardcore.
I did it. So hardcore.
Grego.
HXC.
You did. Didn't Grego just join the team?
Grego just joined VVV.
He joined VVV. Congratulations,
which
Grego.
Does not mean Veni Vidi Vici, which I would just assume.
It means Vision, Valor, Victory, bro.
Yeah, which is English words and not Latin words.
This map is called Daybreak.
Now, it's made by Poor Billy.
This map is made by Poor Billy.
Why did Ryan said this is the first map for this?
That's awful.
It's hilarious.
But I feel like
Vince is attacking
this
already.
Could be a really, really fun map to watch here. It has a grapple hook
Where's
in the middle. But I don't see it being used.
Oh, it's the beginning.
Going to make his way over to the middle here, getting on that top ridge, putting down a shot on Hot Mustard, not able to land anything there. Of course, the roster from MME is Felons, Hot Mustard, and Pop Trunk. We haven't seen our friends in MME for quite some time, by the way.
It's true. We got to meet them at IPL5 the first week of December, but I haven't actually done anything with them, I don't think, since then.
Yeah.
Did they play in Weekly Cup?
It's been some
week after?
Yeah, they did. They did play in the Weekly Cup. But, you know, it's just this is our first, like, real cast. So let's see if Hot Muscle is going to use a grapple. That's, okay, he doesn't use it.
He tried and didn't realize you have to be above.
Yeah.
You have to jump to use it, really.
But it's still a very good grapple to use because it gives you that bridge.
Momentum.
And you don't need to worry about it. You don't need to worry.
Ooh, I like that
nice
move.
Movement.
He needs to hit some lasers, of course, but that was a pretty good move.
If he would have hit a laser after that move, I would have been like, what?
I would have been like, whoa.
What? And
I'd have been like, hey.
And
bam.
Look at this. Oh, what a close
14
shot.
Centimeters. I really like the inclusion of the miss by 14 centimeters because, A, it gives us something more to talk about. Look at that 1 millimeter.
Oh,
1 millimeter miss.
That was his toenail.
That's like 2 pixels. 1 millimeter.
That is the worst. That is the absolute worst. And now Hot Mustard is going to be in a pickle here. Hot Mustard and pickle. Pickled mustard.
Pickled mustard, oh no!
And he's going in for it! Oh,
he tried
man.
The hop, the old hop technique, but Vince was having none of that. He lands that third and final rocket. That was a team ace. That's what they call it in the biz.
Team ace.
When all three of you get the defensive rockets, that is the team ace.
Team ace.
So they team aced Hot Mustard. Poor Billy, let's see if he uses the grapple in his own map that he'd made himself with his bare hands and mouse and keyboard.
He almost landed a shot 1 centimeter on that miss. And rockets flying everywhere. The pressure is going to be applied on Poor Billy. Going to the left side here.
Oh.
Nailing the shot on Felons. Taking him out with a 9.5 meter shot. And now with 20 seconds left on the round here, he sees one defender over by the fence to his right and one up top bridge. So perhaps Poor Billy's going to go.
Nice.
Oh, that was a bad move there by Pop Trunk. Although he did land the hit.
Oh, scary close.
That was.
Nabs a rocket. That's a double rocket.
Oh.
And one thing important to note, when you're shooting rockets, your laser recharges instantly, so you can actually go pew, 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 like if you hit all their rockets.
Yeah.
And it's kind of funny and amusing, but
pretty sick.
It's great if you can drill through all their rockets and then hit them. It's like 5 shots in a row.
Yeah.
But Poor Billy does get eliminated.
On his own map.
Still no successful attacking round, so we'll see who is going to be the first one to make that happen. So yeah, pretty straightforward. These slides don't really do a whole lot. The jump pad is going to get you to your target faster. There's a grapple right here. You can see Pop Trunk making use of it, hopping up on that platform. There's one rail pad somewhere.
In the
there,
back.
Way back there in the back left. Pop Trunk is actually going to just skirt around and not try to mess with that at all. You can see the spin move guys trying to keep track of Pop Trunk, making sure they can keep eyes on him. Pop Trunk's still just checking his six every once in a while to make sure he's okay. And there is a way up, but it's a ramp and it's only one direction, which means these guys can basically surround him. Vince actually making use of that laser pad. Who is that hopping down on the backside there? Nolly Booglin and Poor Billy both waiting back there.
Good
and,
stuff.
Yeah, that was pretty good stuff from spin move. It looks like he was just a little bit lost once he got over to the backside. There wasn't sure of his plan at that point.
Well, that and the fact that he didn't expect that laser.
Yeah, that's
back
true
there,
too.
You know, as soon as he went to that right side, dipped right, went to the grass, he got called out, and they knew where he was going, and someone got ready for that. You know, laser pad control. So that was a good play there by spin move. Now Nolly up to bat here for spin move, going around to the side, not able to land that laser. Felons putting the pressure on him.
Oh, no.
Oh man, just so many exchanges.
I didn't know
here.
You could go behind the laser pad. That actually saved him, I think.
That did. And another hit. He is just a great rocket shooter.
Yeah.
Nolly Booglin.
That is that's an interesting skill to have. It doesn't actually help you win the game.
No, it doesn't.
But you know, it's nice to have fun and shoot a bunch of rockets. I guess, but here we go. Ow. Booglin caught on the hill. He's just Booglin. Just straight Booglin.
Straight Booglin, bro.
He's just totes Booglin.
Totes for Booglin in the
hella,
words of Ryan Mitchell.
Hella totes Booglin.
In the words of Ryan Mitchell, brah.
Brah.
So on our show, we did a new thing with the bullet points.
Yeah.
And Ryan, every time, would just go, bam.
Bam. Like,
every time I was done, he would go, bam.
That's pretty funny.
Every single time. It was actually quite romantic.
Quite romantic?
Yes.
Did he say bam and like kiss you on the cheek or something?
No, that's not right, Josh. Don't
well,
say those.
You said
I'm
it was
married.
Romantic. I don't know.
I don't know. Romance, you know, Ryan's like Romance of the Three Kingdoms, you know, the romantic era. You know,
oh,
when
that kind of romance.
Everything was so
Oh, that was
awesome.
An open shot. Felons misses by 5 centimeters.
Yeah,
that would have been the first successful attack
nice
round, but he gets
shot
it anyway as Booglin just goes straight hella totes Booglin.
Totes Booglin. I don't know. What do we say sometimes? I'm so lost. All right. Vince on the attack for spin move now. And, you know, this map has been proving to be quite entertaining, I must say. You know, some pretty good spots
here.
Reminds
me of Castle Crasher. Yeah. The fence at the front, like, it has to remind you of Castle Crasher.
It really does. If anyone is watching this and, you know, has an opinion on the map, let us know in the
tweet
chat.
Tweet us.
Tweet us, too.
I like tweets.
Yeah, that's right. I actually just, you know, just want to make this announcement.
He's
I broke 10,000 followers on Twitter.
You broke them all?
I broke it. I broke
Man.
Twitter.
You broke Twitter. All right.
So
well,
I'm more,
for
I'm more popular than Josh Sutherland, who is
Frisco.
A famous YouTuber.
That is true, actually. But if you go to twitter.com/JoshSuv, which was my first Twitter account, I decided to restart into hard mode and just go, you know, without advertising myself or anything like that or going on shows or... I'm just kidding.
Oh, really?
I have 23,000 followers combined, so that's pretty
no,
good.
No, you
And 55,000 subs on YouTube and 1,500 likes on Facebook. And probably my grandparents really love me. I don't know if yours do, but
mine. That's
look at that
wow,
pit.
Wow, that is dangerous.
That's a mosh pit.
That is a dangerous pit there.
Sick pit. That's kind of funny.
That's a good. That actually is pretty good because it doesn't end the round right away. You still can get out, but it's tough. That was good.
I wonder if. If they made that pit just like super deep, and if they could wall jump, like force them to wall jump, like
bounce crazy
all the way around the outside, just to get out. Two defenders left. Poor Billy off to a good start here, and spin move is actually still down in this map. So poor Billy has an opportunity to try and tie things up here against Mono.
Yep, he does.
Ooh, misses the shot.
Of
by
course,
10
if he wins this, he wouldn't necessarily tie it up. You know, in attacking rounds, he tie up, which, you know, is, of course, how the game is driven. So if you guys were just confused at home and it's your first time watching, just want to give you the old FYI.
Mm-hmm. The fee, as
the
we call
fee,
it, in the
fee,
biz.
The fee. What's the biz you keep on talking about?
The biz. The Shoemania biz.
And he does, in fact, tie it up with the attack round win 1-1. And now it's going to be 5-4. Pop Trunk attacking for MME, and he could very well put his team back in the lead here. You know, we actually did see a good comment. Silva 9 says that this is definitely Castle Crasher just modified.
Well, if you get rid of all the terrain except for this cage and this point, it looks just like it's the same as Castle Crasher. The rail pad actually hits the same sort of area on the map as well. Pop Trunk actually, while attacking, hopping up on that rail pad. Let's see if he can make use of that zoom function. I don't think he will, but he hops down, misses a shot by 3 centimeters. He's still surrounded, but not getting shot to death. He is going to get cornered here, though, and finish off by poor Billy.
You know, I noticed that there are a lot of little nooks and crannies on this map that really punish the attacker if they're not careful. Like, he fell into that back
this
corner
hole,
there.
This hole, the pits.
Yeah.
There's this pit.
So movement really is important on this map. I wonder why there's a hole there and not a hole on the other side.
I don't know. It's a good hole, I guess, to fall in from time to time. Nolly Booglin just straight totes Booglin. Let's see if he'll boogle it up here or if he'll actually get spin move a lead here on Daybreak. And Daybreak, if you don't know, is a StarCraft II map that was played competitively for a long time. And poor Billy, who designed the map, is a StarCraft II player, Masters level. So that's why he named it Daybreak. It actually looks nothing like
is
the StarCraft II map.
Is he Grand Masters, though?
He is not. He's just Masters.
I'm Masters.
But he's pretty good. He's good at Zerg. He could beat me in StarCraft and
anyone
Shoemania.
Could be you. You don't play
wow.
StarCraft.
That's true, but you didn't have to tell everyone.
Because you play Shoemania.
Yeah, that's right. Because I'm a Shoemania pro. So Felons attacking now. You should have seen the look I just gave Alex.
Yeah, it was a like, real stink
it
face.
It was like the most pathetic, pitiful face. Like, I'm just sad now at you. But here we go. Felons actually already taking out 2 defenders. Booglin.
Wow.
Will he boogle?
Boogle!
Oh, gets boogled.
No.
He got boogled.
Boogling, doogle.
Man, that's a bad time to get boogled.
Oh, we just made a new one. Boogled. So, while I do like the opening of the map, you know, the one thing that you always have to laugh about is the sliding, you know, textures there. Not necessarily useful.
In this case, no. And we saw another map in that first match where you actually took the slide. It was the first map that they played, I believe, was Spitfire. That one actually was good for getting the defenders to the point faster.
Yeah.
But this one, I mean, you can just ignore them and take the jump pad instead. But, you know, if you didn't have the jump pad, maybe you would see people take the slides more. I don't know. But,
Perhaps.
I mean, really all it's doing is giving you a little bit of momentum. The problem is that...
Going against the system.
Yeah, of course. The only problem is if you're on it and you're not moving side to side, like strafing, you can kind of get stuck on it. Like, your momentum can actually get killed almost to a dead stop if you hit it at the wrong angle, and that can really be rough if you're trying to, you know, quickly move around, evade defenders, evade attackers, and you get stuck on something like that. Oh, here we go, falling down on the low ground. This is something Alex Goldenboy Mendez showed us how to do, fall down and not be able to get back up. So we'll see if Hot Mustard... He tried to wall jump off. It's kind of tricky there, too, because it's a corner and it doesn't quite catch every time, but he did manage to get up. Hot Mustard with only one defender left to get through. Boogled!
Wow.
And that's a 9-5 score.
Boogled!
Get boogled! He got boogled.